Wrestling's got to stay out of the ceremony. Oh, photo op.
Eric, thank you very much. Now, firstly, I just want to say, now, I didn't mean, and I didn't want to hurt anybody last night at SummerSlam. I was just doing my job. My boss asked me to do something, and I did it. Does that make me a bad guy? I am proud to serve Eric Bischoff. Because you see...
Uh-oh.
Because you see, Eric Bischoff, he recognizes talent. He recognizes talent unlike Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Listen, this crowd, is that how you pronounce it?
Stone Cold attacked me last night at SummerSlam for no reason whatsoever. I didn't physically provoke Stone Cold. It's a load of crap, and Stone Cold Steve Austin knows it. Stone Cold has had it out for me because unlike some people around here, I'm not his boy.
Oh, look at this.
Isn't that right, JR?
Talking to you.
Hey, Jonathan. He's not going to answer you. Forget about it. I mean, that's not how JR works. I mean, you remember a couple of weeks ago when he came back to the broadcast booth? You remember how he made you feel? In fact, let's show all these other people exactly what I'm talking about. How did this make you feel? Let's roll the tape.
Oh, wait a minute. What is this? It is great to see you. Oh. Oh, what?
I get it.
You get the hint, coach? Come on, what are you waiting on?
You know, Eric.
Yeah, like you really mean that handshake, coach. No, I'm sure you do.
I was genuinely hurt by that. I mean, here I was carrying the ball for JR. And not only did I wish JR well time after time after time, you heard me. But, you know, it was so funny that when I was filling in for JR, I filled in so smoothly, they didn't even know that he was gone. And what did I get in return? I didn't get a thanks, coach. Attaboy, way to be a team player. No, all I got was this mean scowl as if to say, get out of my chair, boy. I thought that JR was more of a professional than that. Apparently not. Oh, I want an apology from you, JR. And one day, I'm damn sure gonna get that. But right now, I want an apology from Stone Cold Steve Austin for attacking me last night.
What?
And I want that apology right now.
Well, I don't know quite what to say.
What the hell?
What the hell? Does Coach think he bosses Stone Cold Steve Austin around now or something?
That's not Stone Cold. That's the Intercontinental Champion, Christian.
So you think you deserve an apology from Stone Cold? Well, you got a point. But let me tell you something. Nobody deserves an apology around here more than me. At least you were on SummerSlam. I'm the Intercontinental Champion, damn it. I'm the people's choice. And Stone Cold intentionally kept me off that show, just like he's trying to keep me off this show. But look around you, man. These people love me. He's denying my population their daily dose of...
Well, ask and you shall receive. I don't
provoke the Texas Rattlesnake here tonight. You know, Eric Bischoff did warn Steve Austin to stay out of this Employee of the Month presentation. So much for warning a rattlesnake, right?
Austin's got as much right out here as Bischoff does, or the co-general managers of this broadcast, and these fans on their feet at the sight of the rattlesnake here. This night gets more bizarre and stranger by the moment.
I love it, baby. It's raw.
Let me get this straight. You said that you were carrying the ball for JR while he was gone. I'm going to put it to you real straight and simple, real honest as I can put it. Jesus Christ, son, you couldn't carry JR's jockstrap. And you want an apology out of me? Is that what you're trying to tell me? You want Stone Cold Steve Austin to say, I'm sorry. Let me think about it. No, I don't think I'm going to apologize to you, but what I did do, I brought you a little sympathy card. Remember, I got the little card for you here.
Sympathy card?
That's up. Jazz got your little name written on it right there.
Big sympathy card for Coach.
Uh-oh! Well, that's somewhat explicit.
Now wait a second.
It's not from Hallmark,
now you can
is it?
You can make all the hand gestures you want, but Stone Cold, as Raw GM, you know your hand-picked broadcasters are a joke. You've got a cowboy, and you've got a king. What is this, the Village People?
That's real cute.
Hey. Can I say something? Stone Cold. If Coach thinks that I'm such a joke, why don't I come down there and stick that little award in the only place in Arizona that the sun doesn't shine? Huh?
Oh, whoa, 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 excuse me, Intercontinental Champion over here, and I'm really starting to get pissed off, and I'm tired of being ignored, and you know what I'm going to do about it? Do you know what I'm going to do?
You're gonna shut your stinking hole. That's exactly what you're gonna do. You sit there and you come out and you piss and you moan how Stone Cold left y'all SummerSlam. You think you're special with your little elbow pads, your wrist pads, your little orange trunks, your black boots, your Intercontinental Championship. Well, you want some action, you little creepy bastard. Stone Cold Steve Austin is going to give you some action. So I'm going to see fit right here in this ring to make a little match right here on Raw. It's going to be Christian against Jerry the King Lawler. Shut up. Take your stupid little glasses off, you pile of trash. You make me sick. Stand back, son, I'll drop you like a bad habit. You damn right, speaking of Jerry Lawler, since you are the Intercontinental Champion in this match, the Intercontinental title will be on the line.
All right.
And that's the bottom line, because Stone Cold sucks up.